Who is God calling you to be? Well, last week we said that God has given you a unique set of skills to live out the call that God has placed on your life. And today we're going to come back and talk about how do we identify those spiritual gifts that God has given us and how do we put them into practice. So I just want to spend a couple of minutes talking about how we figure out how God has gifted us. How do we figure out this calling God has put in our lives uniquely with the spiritual gifts God has given me and God has given you? Now, spiritual surveys are great, and we'll link one in the comments. So if you have never taken a spiritual gift survey, please take one. They're fun. But I think there's some additional ways that are extremely helpful for us to figure out what our spiritual gifts are. And so I've got three quick ways to share with you, three quick questions to ask. And the first one is this. Ask yourself, what are you good at and what brings you joy? What are things that you enjoy doing, but you also have ability in? Because at the intersection of your ability and the things that bring you joy is going to be a gift. It's going to be a certain spiritual gift that God has given to you, and he's calling you to use that gift. See, there may be something that you're really good at, but you just don't enjoy doing. And when you do those things, it just kind of grows you weary. You might be really good at it, you don't enjoy it, so you get weary doing it. On the other hand, there's certain things that you really enjoy, that you really love, you're just not very good at. And so at the end of the day, you just get really frustrated. But what happens when at the intersection of ability and enjoyment, you find the gift that God has given you? So maybe you love being around people and you love starting up conversations with people and it comes naturally to you and that you enjoy it. Maybe you have the gift of hospitality. Or for you, maybe you're a very organized people and you love helping other people get organized. For you, you may have the gift of administration. Seeing what you enjoy and what you're good at come together is a beautiful thing. And to you, it'll identify some areas that you're gifted at. But I think there's a second question we have to ask. Not just what are we good at and what do we enjoy, but what do others have to say about me? What do others say that you're gifted at? What are others telling you that you're good at? And this involves active listening and being around people and letting them speak into our lives. But what are people complimenting you about? When people say something to you, what do they say? Someone in your life group might tell you that they love to talk to you, that you're such an encourager. Maybe that means you have the gift of encouragement. Maybe somebody else says to you that every time you speak up, they learn something from you. And you didn't realize it before, but you are a gifted teacher. The people around you, they want to speak into your life, just like you should be speaking into their life. And so that's one great way for us to identify what we are good at. Maybe people tell you that they love to talk to you and that you help them through difficult spiritual and emotional times. Maybe you have the gift of helps. And so I think there's so much we can learn by letting others speak into our lives. But also ask someone that you trust. Ask that close friend at church. Ask somebody that's in your life group, hey, what am I good at? What areas do you see that I'm gifted in? And let them speak into your life. So I think those are really two good questions to ask. But there's a third question that I think complements those. And that third question is this. What opportunities exist around you? What opportunities are available for you to serve and to be a part of what God is doing? Because there's this beautiful marriage of our ability and God's opportunities that God brings together to give us opportunities to use those gifts. Notice again what Paul says in Romans 12. He says this in verse 6, that we have different gifts according to the grace given to each of us. And he gives us a kind of a run-on of a few gifts here. He says, if your gift is prophesying, then prophecy in accordance with your faith. If it is serving, then serve. If it's teaching, then teach. If it's to encourage, then give encouragement. If it's giving, then give generously. If it's to lead, do it diligently. If it's to show mercy, do it cheerfully. Notice at the heart of what Paul says is, use your gift. And so I think part of identifying our gifts is to say, what is available and what opportunities exist? Because as I get into those opportunities, I will quickly discover what I'm good at. You may find that around you at church, around you in the environment where you're around God's people, that there are certain available opportunities to jump in. And when you get into those, you start to discover man, I'm pretty good at this. Or you might say, this might not be the right fit for me. You may not feel like you have the gift of teaching, but you see that kids ministry needs some helpers. You get in, you might realize that you have the serious gift of service. And it's a perfect fit. So sometimes I think we just need to step in and to begin to use our gifts. We might realize that this is an area I'm really gifted in, or maybe it's not. But God will use those experiences to help us to identify the gifts He's given me in my life and help me to begin to live out that call to be a part of the church. And so that we can help God's church, the body of believers, to be the best version of itself. So as we wrap up our time today, I just want you to ask yourself this week, do you know what your gifts are? What has God uniquely gifted you to do and to be inside the body of Christ? What gifts has God given you to serve one another, to serve the church? And once you identify what those gifts are, maybe you already know, are you using those gifts? Are you using those gifts to build up the body of Christ? And second, if you don't know what your gift is or what your gifts are, get on a mission to find out. Ask these questions, talk to the people around you, and step in and give your time and volunteer, and God will show you exactly how He's gifted you to live out the call for your life to be the people of God. Well, Forefront, I'm excited for us to be on this journey together. This is Pastor Drew signing off. I love you. I'll see you soon. Blessings.